Dear students, yesterday we discussed about introduction of electrochemistry and electrochemical cell, construction of electrochemical cell and representation of electrochemical cell. Now again I'll revise that. We know what is the electrochemical cell? The cell which is convert chemical energy into electrical energy through a redox reactions is called as electrochemical cell. In the case of electrochemical cell, totally two half cells are there. One is oxidation half cell, another one is reduction half cell. So these two half cells are, we can made in a separate compartments. When these two compartments are connected through external wire as well as salt grids, the overall cell will be filled. So in this case, for the electrochemical cell, the best example is Daniell cell. Electrochemical cell is also called as galvanic cell or voltaic cell. We know that. Why? Because the scientist Volta and Galvani was made first that electrochemical cell. That's why it is called as a galvanic cell or voltaic cell. For this galvanic cell or voltaic cell, the best example is Daniell cell. In the Daniell cell, the zinc rod is dipped in zinc sulfate solution in one compartment. Copper rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution in another compartment like this. This is the zinc rod is dipped in zinc sulfate solution. Copper rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution. Next, in the case of galvanic cell, again one more salt bridge is used. This is the salt bridge. This is the salt bridge. Why we can use this salt bridge means this salt bridge is actually a U-shaped tube. This U-shaped tube is filled with some of the inert electrolytes like potassium chloride or potassium nitrate or ammonium nitrate. What is the need of this salt bridge means? This salt bridge is having some significance. What is that significance? First one is it connects the solutions of two half cells and complete the cell circuit. That is first significant. Second significant, it prevents transference or diffusion of the solution from one half cell to another half cell. It is second significant. The third significant is it keeps the solution in two half cells electrically neutral. In how it is possible means in anodic half cell, positive ions pass into the solution and there shall be an accumulation of extra positive charge in the solution around the anode, which will prevent the flow of electrons from anode. This does not happen. Actually, this does not happen. Why? Because negative ions are provided by this salt bridge. Negative ions are provided by this salt bridge. Next. Similarly, in cathode. Cathode means the right hand side the compartment or reduction of cell is called as a cathode. So in the case of cathode half cell, the negative ions will be accumulate around the cathode due to deposition of positive ions by reduction. To neutralize these negative ions, sufficient number of positive ions are provided by this salt bridge. Next, this salt bridge is also having one more significant, that is it prevents liquid-liquid junction potential. So this is the use of salt bridge and significance of salt bridge. Actually, in the case of galvanic cell, the anode is having negative charge and cathode has positive charge. So anode has negative charge and cathode has positive charge. In electrolytic cell, these signs are opposite. Next, we know how to represent the galvanic cell. Yesterday we discussed during the representation of galvanic cell, the anode is always right left hand side and cathode is always right hand side. And cathode as well as anode is separated by salt bridge by the vertical lines. During the representation of anode first you should write a metal and write a class and then write a metal ion and keep two vertical lines now. So up to now one half cell is finished, and then you have to keep two vertical lines. So during the representation of cathode, first you should write positive ion and then write neutral metal atom by separating or by differentiating with slash. For example, once you see here like this, so here we represented like this. We have to represent this is anode, this is cathode. The anode as well as cathode both are separated with a salt bridge like this. This is the salt bridge. The two vertical lines is called as a salt bridge. So next, now I'm going to discuss about other examples for galvanic cell. So up to now I discussed Daniell cell is one of the important example for the galvanic cell. So in the case of Daniell cell, we have to immersed zinc rod in zinc sulfate solution. It is act as a anode or oxidation of cell, and in another compartment copper rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution. It is act as a cathode. So the overall cell reaction we can observe. Before going to discuss about the overall cell reaction, in each compartment or at anode or cathode, which type of chemical reactions are occur, once you see. In cathode, the copper ions are converted into copper metal. That means the copper ions are deposited on copper metal. Simultaneously in anode, the zinc metal is converted into zinc ions. That's mean in cathode, the aqueous copper ions are converted into solid copper metal, and in anode, the solid zinc metal is converted into zinc ions. So this is oxidation of reaction and this is reduction of reaction. In the anode, oxidation is occur, that's why it is called as a oxidation of reaction. At cathode, reduction is occur, that's why it is called as a reduction of reactions. When the overall cell, if you want to represent overall cell reaction, you should add both the half reactions. When you add both the half reactions, what happened here? Two electrons cancel together and add now zinc solid plus copper plus 2 aqueous solution gives rise to zinc plus 2 in aqueous solution and copper solid. This is the representation of Daniell cell. Okay, so according to IUPAC system, the cell may represent like this. Now I am going to discuss about one more galvanic cell, that is gold lead cell. The gold lead cell is, we can represent like this. So here the lead is act as a anodic of cell or oxidation of cell, and iron is act as a cathodic of cell, or gold is act as a cathodic of cell or reduction of cell. So generally the lead is loses electrons at anode and converted into lead ions. Simultaneously in reduction of cell, the gold iron plus 3 ions are accept electrons and converted into iron metal. So how we can construct this means, in first compartment you have to take a small amount of lead chloride or lead sulfate solution and dip the lead metal. In another compartment you have to take either aric chloride or aram sulfate solution and dip gold rods. So these two rods are connected through external wire. Finally that two compartments are connected through a salt bridge. Finally the cell will be finished. The overall cell reaction we have to represent like this. For getting of overall reaction, I already said both the half reactions we have to add together. So here also the anodic half reaction or oxidation of reaction is 3Pb solid gives rise to 3Bb plus 2 aqueous plus 6 electrons. This 6 electrons is accepted by 3 aryl-coons and converted into gold metal. And finally, both are added. Here also 6 electrons, 6 electrons cancel together. Finally, 3 lead solid plus 2 aryl plus 3 aqueous solution gives rise to, it is 2. So 2 aryl atoms. Next, another half galvanic cell is there, that is copper silver galvanic cell. During the construction of copper silver galvanic cell, the copper metal is act as a anode and it is act as a oxidation of reaction or oxidation of cell, and it silver metal is act as a cathode, and silver metal is dipped in silver electrolyte and copper metal is dipped in copper electrolyte, and both are connected through external wire and through a salt bridge also. So generally here the copper metal is undergo oxidation by loss of electrons, and silver metal is converted into silver metal ions are converted into silver metal by the accepting of electrons. Copper solid is converted into copper ions, and silver ions are converted into silver metal. So generally this is occur in anodic half cell, this is occur in cathodic half cell, and both are add together. Finally, we can get a overall cell reaction. The overall cell reaction is copper solid plus 2Az plus aqueous solution gives rise to Cu plus 2 aqueous plus 2Az solid. This is about the different electrolyte galvanic cells. So now we are going to discuss about some problems on this topic. First of all, take a question. The given question is, construct the cells in which the following reactions are taking place. Which of the electrode cell act as a anode and which one act as a cathode? They have given totally 3 cell reactions. Among these 3 cell reactions, you have to first construct cell and as well as which is act as a anode and which one is act as a cathode, you have to represent, and you should write overall cell reaction also. So here the given chemical reaction is, first one, A, Fe plus SnCl2 gives rise to FeCl2 plus Sn. Here in this reaction A, once you observe carefully, iron is converted into Fe plus 2 state. Iron is converted into Fe plus 2 state. That's mean it is undergo oxidation. It is undergo oxidation. And Sn from plus 2 state to converted into neutral state. Metal, here the metal is converted into metal ion, and here metal ion is converted into metal. So in this reaction, in that reaction A, iron is oxidized to Fe plus 2 ion and Sn plus 2 is reduced to Sn. So the cell can be represented as, we know already generally the oxidation is occurrent anode. The anode half cell is always represented left hand side. So here this is the anodic half cell. We can write like this. Iron is converted into iron ion, ferrous ion. Simultaneously, generally the chemical substance which is undergo reduction is occur in cathodic half cell. That's why you can represent like this. Sn plus 2 state to Sn is converted. The stannous, it is converted from plus 2 state to neutral state. The metal ion, stannous metal ion, is converted into stannous. That's why it is a reduction. This reduction is occur always in cathodic of reaction. So that's why we have to according to IUPAC system, the cathode is always represent on the right hand side. We have to represent the right hand side. Both the half cells are separated with a salt bridge, isn't it? That salt bridge is right with the two vertical lines like this. This is the overall reaction. This electrochemical cell we can also write like this. So Fe, a small slash here, the Fe is separate with its ionic form. So here oxidation is occurring, that's why it is an anode. So here the Sn plus 2 is converted into Sn, it is reduction, it is represented as a cathode. And both half cells are separate out with the help of salt beads, that is denoted with two vertical slashes. Two slashes are two vertical lines. So in this cell reaction, the how we can observe which type of half reactions are occur once you see. Generally in anode or in oxidation of cell, this type of reaction is occur. Iron is loses two electrons and converted into Fe plus 2 ion in aqueous state from solid state. It is converted into aqueous state from solid state. Simultaneously, the aqueous Sn plus 2 ions are converted into solid Sn in another compartment, that is cathodic half cell or reduction of cell, like this. The overall reaction we can observe like this. The overall reaction is iron when react with Sn plus 2, it is converted into Fe plus 2 plus Sn. This is overall reaction. Finally, again, the anode is iron and cathode is tin. And half reactions are in oxidation of reaction, iron is converted into iron ion. In reduction of reaction, tin ion is converted into tin. Next, question B. In the question B, once you observe zinc metal is react with H2SO4 and produce zinc sulfate and hydrogen gas. This is the second question. So once you observe here carefully, in this reaction, the zinc is converted from neutral state to plus 2 state. Hydrogen is converted from plus 1 state to neutral state or zero oxidation state. So in this reaction, we simply understand the zinc is undergo oxidation, hydrogen is undergo reduction, isn't it? So with the help of that, I conclude, in this case, zinc is oxidized to Zn plus 2 ion, and H plus ion is reduced to hydrogen gas. According to our concept, we can write the overall cell reaction like this, or we can represent the cell like this. Zinc metal should be dipped in its electrolyte. That means zinc is dipped in zinc sulfate and sulfuric acid is present. Here, zinc is dipped in zinc sulfate, it is act as a anode or oxidation of reaction. Here, zinc and electrolyte, that means metal and electrolyte, we have to separate with a slash like this. So, it is one of the half cell. And another half cell, H2SO4, and here hydrogen gas is liberated, we have to represent it like this. So, ionic form to reduced form, we have to represent like this. Both the half cells are separated with a salt bridge like this. Next, we can also represent that reaction in the ionic form like this. Zinc metal is separate with its zinc ion with a small slash. And this is one of the half cell. This half cell is separated with another half cell like this. And in another half cell, H plus ions are converted into hydrogen gas. So here the zinc is act as an anode, and here platinum hydrogen is a gas itself, it is not act as a electrode. That's why here we have to use a inert electrode, that is platinum. Platinum is act as a cathode, but however at cathode hydrogen ion is converted into hydrogen gas. The half reactions we have to see. In the anodic of a cell, this type of reaction is converted. Zinc solid is converted into zinc ions by the liberation of two electrons, as well as in cathode two hydrogen ions are accept two electrons and liberated hydrogen gas. Here when you sum the two off reactions, two electrons are cancelled together, and finally zinc solid is converted into aqueous zinc ions and H plus ions are converted into hydrogen gas. So this is the overall reaction. Next, C is there. So dear students, you have to practice this C. So according to this concept only, you have to practice this C and you will get the answer. So this is your homework. Next, I am going to discuss about function of galvanic cell when external potential is applied. Generally, the galvanic cell is a combination of two half cells. One is oxidation of cell, another one is reduction of cell. So when the cell construction is completed, the electricity is produced. That is, we have to measure it by the as a EMF value of the cell. So however, what happens when external potential is applied? Once you see, if the EMF value of external battery is less than the EMF value of voltaic cell, the current flow from the cell to the battery. Again, if the EMF value of external battery is less than the EMF value of voltaic cell, the current flow from the cell to battery. Next, another condition: if the EMF value of external battery is more than the EMF value of voltaic cell or galvanic cell, current flow from the battery into voltaic cell. So that's mean when the EMF value of battery is greater than EMF value of the cell, at that time the current is always flow from battery to cell. Next, when the EMF value of external battery is equal to EMF value of galvanic cell, no current flow in the reaction, that condition is called as a, or no current is flowing in that galvanic cell, that condition is called as a equilibrium condition. Generally, the EMF value of the cell we have to calculate it like standard reduction potential value of cathode minus standard reduction potential value of anode. For Daniell cell, the standard EMF value is, or E cell is, 1.1 electron volts. Now I'm going to supply some amount of current through the Daniell cell, and we can see which type of observations we have to observe. So once you see here, in first case, this is the Daniell cell, this is oxidation of cell, this is reduction of cell, this is salt bridge, and this is external wire, and this is external battery. So here once you observe, in this case the EMF value of external battery is less than, in the first case I am telling, is less than when compared with the EMF value of galvanic cell or Daniell cell. Actually Daniell cell EMF value is 1.1 volts, but external battery is less than 1.12. At that time, what happened? The electrons are flow from here. The current is always flow from cell to battery. I already said that one. How it is for when the current is flow from battery to external source? When the electrons are flow from anode to cathode. When the electrons are flow from anode to cathode, the current is flow from cathode to anode. So when it is happen, the electrons are always flow from anode to cathode. At that time only the current is supplied to external source, isn't it? So now here cathode is copper rod and anode is zinc rod. So now the electrons are flow from zinc rod to copper rod. Zinc rod to copper rod. Hence the current is flow from copper to zinc. Next, zinc dissolves at cathode. Sorry, zinc dissolves at anode and copper deposited at cathode. This observation we have to observe when the external battery which is connected to the Daniell cell is having less EMF value when compared with the Daniell cell. Next, once you observe in the B condition, B, the external source of battery is equal to EMF value of Daniell cell. In this condition, there is no flow of electrons and there is no flow of current. The chemical reaction should be in the equilibrium condition. No chemical reactions are occurring. So once you observe here there is no flow of current or flow of electrons, and finally the reaction is in equilibrium state. Next, in third condition, once you observe, when the external source of battery EMF value is greater than EMF value of Daniell cell, at that time the current is flow from battery to cell. In this case, the cell is act as an electrolytic cell. Here the electrons are flow from copper to zinc, here to here. So simultaneously, now when the external battery EMF value is greater than Daniell cell, the zinc is deposited at anode or at zinc electrode, and copper is dissolved at copper electrode at cathode or This is the conditions. So that means when external energy is passed through the external source of current is passed through the galvanic cell, this type of observations we have to observe. So